Today we'll learn the anatomy of the liver. Hello, can you hear me properly?
Yes, ma'am.
Today we are going to learn about the liver. Liver, you know, it is situated, where exactly it is situated in our abdomen? Can anybody tell me? Which region of our abdomen? Okay. But let me tell you that liver is the largest gland in our body. It is both exocrine and endocrine gland. So you know that there are endocrine glands in our body, like pituitary gland and other the exocrine glands, like pancreas is also an exocrine gland. Exocrine means it directly sends its enzymes or its hormones to the blood. It is called as exocrine gland. And endocrine means it has some channels through which it these enzymes or these hormones passes to the blood. So such endocrine and exocrine, both functions are done by the liver. So you know that liver has it is the largest gland, and it is reddish and brown in color. If you observe the color of the liver in your book, that it looks like a reddish brown in color. And the average weight of this liver is approximately 1500 grams. So in male, it may be more than 1500 grams, like 1600 or 1700. And in females, it may be 1300 grams. Up to the 1300 grams. So I will run small YouTube video. From that, you will learn the location, shape, and the ligaments and the lobes of liver properly. So just wait. I am sharing one video with you. Can everybody see this video? Hello?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, it is visible, but it is not audible.
It's not audible.
Yes, ma'am.
Just I'm starting this video. Can you hear it now?
No, ma'am.
Can you hear this?
No, ma'am.
It's audible now?
No, ma'am, it is not audible.
Hello?
It is not audible.
It's audible?
No, ma'am.
This notch has also got another name. What is another name is, just behind, below this notch, you find a small ligament here. This ligament is called Very good. This is called as ligamentum teres. So I can also call this notch as notch for ligamentum teres. Okay, I can call this notch as notch for ligamentum teres. You are clear so far? When you look at the liver, liver has got two notches. You see here, liver has got two notches. Okay, this notch is called as cystic notch. This is called as cystic notch. Why you call it a cystic notch? Because back of that you have gallbladder, so which is lightly projecting below the liver. So actually this is the gallbladder behind the liver. That is why called a cystic notch. The next thing is, you call this part as what? Interlobular notch, right? Why? Because this is the notch where it divides the liver into right and left lobe. On the anterior surface, it divides the liver into right and left lobe. Clear? This notch has also got another name. What is another name is, just behind, below this notch, you find a small ligament here. This ligament is called? Very good. This is called as ligamentum teres. So I can also call this notch as notch for ligamentum teres. Okay, I can call this notch as notch for ligamentum teres. You are clear so far? You are getting bored? I am getting bored. Look now. Now, here, in the center, you have a ligament. There is a ligament in the center. Now, this ligament in the center, which goes on to the back. Now, this ligament is called as what? Falciform ligament. Now, why it is so important is, look here. This is called falciform ligament. Now, normally what happens is, the peritoneum, okay? The peritoneum folds over this falciform ligament. What do I mean is, there are folds of peritoneum which are stretching on either side of the falciform ligament. You see, there are folds of peritoneum which are stretching on either side of falciform ligament. Here also, there are folds of peritoneum. These folds of peritoneum are stretching on either side of falciform ligament. Now what happens is, these folds increase in number, and at one time all these folds together come down and form a sheath which is narrow, right? All of them, they form a sheath which is narrow. Now during the embryonic development, this is the right side, so here I will have the umbilicus, here I will have the liver. So this is the umbilicus. From here you have what? Umbilical vein, right? Now this umbilical vein enters into this sheath, right? And after entering into the sheath, what will happen is, it will go on to the back side of the liver. Right? Now as the developmental process is taking place, slowly this umbilical vein starts to degenerate. But not completely. This part of the umbilical vein, it will become so condensed and so thick that finally it will form a ligament, and that ligament is called as ligamentum teres. Okay? So if I ask you, what is ligamentum teres? Ligamentum teres is a remnant of umbilical vein. It means the remaining part of umbilical vein. Clear? You are clear? So this is ligamentum teres. Now, next thing is, these folds of peritoneum, they increase so much that they go up all the way to the superior surface of the liver. Okay? They go all the way onto the top of the liver. And on the top surface of the liver, they become so thick. Now, they become thick and they cover the entire top surface of the liver or the superior surface of the liver like a crown. you know the crown, right? Like a crown. So this thick part covers like a crown. At later on, this entire fold becomes so thick and forms a ligament here. Now this ligament is called as crown. Crown means what? Coronary ligament. Okay, coronary ligament. Clear? Now this coronary ligament stretches out onto the right side of the liver and ends up forming a triangular shaped ligament like this. In the same way, the coronary ligament on the left also stretches out and ends up forming another triangular ligament. So you call this as a right triangular ligament, you call this as a left triangular ligament. So far, how many ligaments you are aware of? One is ligament falciform ligament, ligamentum teres, coronary ligament, right triangular ligament, and left triangular ligament. Five ligaments. And how many lobes do you have? Right lobe and left lobe. Okay, this is the right side and left side. How many surfaces of the liver we have, generally tell me? This which you can see is anterior surface, this is inferior, and still posterior. And wait, for example, look here.
Get more milk, pay less money. Buy 1 month of milk, get 1 week free. Plus, free super.
You understood this? This is the liver. Now, this one is the top surface, superior surface of the liver. So, we have got superior surface of the liver. Second one, see, you see this part here, inferior surface or inferior border of the liver, this one. Okay? Which you can see here, this is called anterior. Back of that, you will have posterior. And this one is called the right lateral surface of the liver. Okay, right lateral. So liver has got five surfaces. Clear? Right? What is the prominent border? If I ask you, what is the prominent border of the liver? The prominent border of the liver is made up of this one, the inferior part. So this entire inferior part or inferior border of the liver is also called as a prominent border of the liver. Now if I ask you, what are the notches of the prominent border of the liver? It has got two notches, cystic notch and interlobular notch. Clear? Now, having said the surfaces, if I turn the liver this is the liver which you are seeing from the anterior side. Now, if I turn back, how does the picture look? Okay? That is right, so this will be right, and these two are left surfaces. Okay, now this coronary ligament, the right triangular and the left triangular ligament, they flip back onto the liver. When they flip back, so this is how it looks. This is your right coronary ligament, right triangular ligament, and here you have got what? This is the left triangular ligament. This is your left triangular ligament. Actually, from the right side, it has flipped back like this. Flipped back in this way. So, this is your right triangular and this is your left triangular. Any confusion so far? No? Right. Now, right triangular, left triangular, right? Now, here it has formed a special ligament here. Now, this ligament in the center here is called as what? This ligament here, this is called as ligamentum venosum. So far all the ligaments we have discussed. Okay, now continuing down to the ligamentum venosum, we have got another structure like this. This is called porta hepatis. Why it is called porta hepatis? Because porta hepatis has got what? Porta hepatis has got hepatic artery, right? It has got a portal vein, and it is also bile duct. You call it as porta hepatis. Very, very important. Okay, porta hepatis is very important. Clear? So this here was your what was here? Ligamentum teres, which went on to the back. I told you, right? So ligamentum teres came up like this from the front. It went up back like this. You see? Okay. Any doubt? Next thing is the cystic notch, where you have the gallbladder. See, this is the place where you have the gallbladder. Gallbladder. Now, these are the structures that are presented on the posterior side. Now, here you have got two important lobes. See here, this lobe is called as caudate lobe, and this lobe you called as quadrate lobe. Clear? So how many lobes do we have? On the anterior surface, right lobe, left lobe, and on the posterior surface, you have caudate lobe and quadrate lobe. Okay. What is important is you have to know where the liver is located, the position of the liver, right hypochondrium, epigastrium, that thing. Second important question is what is this ligamentum teres? Third important question is what are the ligaments of the liver? Fourth important question is what are the contents of portal triad or porta hepatis? The fifth important question is what are the borders of caudate lobe and what are the borders of quadrate lobe? You tell me now, what are the borders of caudate lobe here? See, on the right side, what do you have? But before that, you should know that there is a vein that is coming inside. What is this? Portal vein is here. This is called as inferior vena cava. Inferior vena cava exits out through the liver also, right? This is called inferior vena cava. So on the right side, what do you have? Inferior vena cava. And on the left side, what do you have? Ligamentum venosum. And inferiorly, I mean below, what do you have? Porta hepatis, right? On the top, what do you have above? Which coronary? The coronary ligament, I'm sorry, coronary ligament. So these are the borders of caudate lobe. Coming to the borders of quadrate lobe. Quadrate lobe, inferiorly, I mean below, what is this? No, below the inferior border of the liver. Inferior border of liver. On the right side, what do you have? Gallbladder. On the left side, what do you have? Very good, ligamentum teres. On the top, above, what do you have? Porta hepatis. So if you have to know these borders, very, very important. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Video was audible to everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Yes. Now you have got the exact idea of how this liver is located and what are the lobes, how many lobes liver have?
Two lobes
only?
Four lobes, ma'am.
Four lobes. Which are they?
Anterior side and posterior side.
Which are they? Right and left lobes. Anteriorly and posteriorly, it has caudate lobes and
caudate and quadrate lobes.
Correct. And how many surfaces liver has? Surfaces?
Five surfaces.
Anterior, posterior, superior, inferior, and right lateral. Correct. And the prominent border is inferior border. Correct. And how many ligaments are there in the attached with the liver?
Five.
Five. Which are they?
ligamentum teres.
Ligamentum teres.
Falciform ligament.
And?
Coronary ligament.
Coronary, correct.
And more? Ligamentum venosum.
Ligamentum venosum, correct. And there are two more ligaments, right triangular ligament and?
Left triangular ligament.
Triangular ligament. So total there are six ligaments which are attached with the liver. So these are very important ligaments. You should know that. So next comes the arterial supply of the liver. You know, you while describing the liver, you should know whatever the features of the liver, like this weight and size and color of liver first, then second time the location of liver. Location is right hypochondrium, epigastric up to the left hypochondrium, correct? And shape, it has a vase shape. So you have to describe the shape of a liver also. Then five surfaces, borders, lobes, all these structures you have to mention while describing the liver. Now next comes the histology. Histological structure we'll see afterwards. First we'll learn the blood supply of liver. So, liver is supplied by two arteries, two things. First is hepatic artery, okay, and second is portal vein. So, this portal vein, it collects, you know, this portal vein come from the, from where it comes? Portal vein. Portal vein comes from all your intestine. You have intestine and large and small intestine. So all the digested food enters in the small intestine and large intestine. And from that borders of intestine, we get this structure, anastomosis of all the veins which drain all to the portal vein. So portal vein contains all the nutrients from the abdomen. From the intestine, correct? Whatever food we digest, it converted into the some biochemical substances, and that substances are absorbed by this portal vein, correct? And these this portal vein, it goes towards the liver. And now this digested or assimilated the food items like carbohydrates and fats and proteins. These are in minute biochemical structures. These structures comes into the liver, and liver, what is the function of liver? To metabolize all these structures and to store these glycogen in the form of, it stores the carbohydrate in the form of glycogen and storing of all these nutrients. And if there is any toxin, toxic material in that portal vein, what does liver do? It detoxifies all these things. So the function of liver is first to it absorbs all the nutrients from the through the portal vein, and it helps to metabolize all the carbohydrates, proteins, and fat. And second is it helps into the storage of that atoms also, like storage of glucose in the form of glycogen. So the main 80% of supply of liver, it comes from the portal vein, and only 20% blood supply comes from hepatic artery, which is the direct branch from the, iski branch hoti hai ye? Abdominal aorta. Abdominal aorta jo niche descend hota hai heart se, heart ke arteries se. So, वहाँ से ये directly hepatic artery, it comes out and it supplies to the liver. So, liver has two blood supply arteries. First from the portal vein and second from the hepatic artery. Now, the venous supply or venous drainage is from, as you know that there are hepatocytes, like the minute histological structure of liver is hepatocytes. Every organ has a cellular structure. You know, the unit of every organ is a cell. So what is the cell of liver is called as hepatocyte. So these hepatocytes, they are arranged in a hexagonal manner, hexagonal like structure. And each, they have a central vein in between them. So central vein, it drains all the lobular and interlobular venous supply and it goes through the hepatic vein and it directly opens into the inferior vena cava. So venous drainage is from central veins to the hepatic veins and then ultimately it drains into the inferior vena cava. So this is the structure for venous drainage. And now lymphatic structure. You know that the lymph is a fluid, white fluid like structure which comes out from the which has a separate circulatory system for them. So lymphatic drainage, it drains all the lymphs which is coming from the liver. It drains all the lymph into the hepatic lymph nodes or celiac lymph nodes or pericardial lymph nodes. So these are the lymph nodes present around the liver and all these lymph drains into these lymph nodes. So nerve supply is again hepatic plexus. Hepatic plexus means it has some nerve supply which nerve supply directly from the parasympathetic and sympathetic branches and it forms the hepatic plexus around the around this porta hepatis. You know that these nerve plexuses, they enter through this porta hepatis to the liver. So these are these things you should know, that blood supply, the venous drainage, the lymphatic drainage and nerve supply of the liver. Now next we will learn the histology of the liver. Histology, as I told you, the cell of liver is called as hepatocyte and they are arranged in a sac-like structure. I will show you one diagram which will help you to understand the structure of hepatocytes. Before that, you should know that liver is covered under a capsule, Gibson. It's a Gleason capsule-like structure it has and it is under that capsule, liver is listed. And this capsule covers entire liver. So, as I told you, these hepatocytes are they are arranged in a hexagonal structure. Hexagonal structure. I'm going to share the diagram with you. So this is the structure of a hexagonal structure of hepatocytes. Now here you see that these blue colored plate-like structure, square, small square-like structure, blue colored, these are the hepatocytes. Now you see that your hepatocytes are arranged in a plate-like structure. It's a one upon one, they are arranged like this, hepatocytes. And you know that hexagon, it has six borders. And at each angle, we have this hepatic artery and portal vein. You know that portal vein and hepatic artery, they branches out and they give each branch to the each angle of this hexagon. Got me? At each angle of this hexagon, we have portal artery branch and the hepatic artery branch. So these two arteries, they open in a sinusoid. In the center, you can see there is a central vein. The purple color is a central vein. Okay. Now all this blood coming from portal artery and hepatic vein, they open in a sinusoid. Sinusoid is a space between these hepatocytes. In every triangle, we have hepatocytes. Here we can see only two triangles are filled with hepatocytes, but all the triangles here in between, they are filled with hepatocytes or hepatic cells. Okay. Now, in between these hepatic cells, there is a sinusoid. Sinusoid means gap between these two hepatic cells. And this sinusoids, they drain the all the hepatic blood, arterial blood, correct, coming from portal vein and hepatic artery. So in between, we can find this in between sinusoids, that black colored dots, they are, that is the direction of blood flowing from outer side to the central vein. And when this blood flows from outer angle to the central vein, there are some from the sinusoids. Sinusoids, they have small pore-like structures on the outer side. So that blood, it mixes with, or these blood goes, it supplies to the hepatic cell. Now, all the nutrients or all the arterial oxygenated blood, if we get in this to the this hepatic cells, okay? And now this blood drains into the central artery because it now, and it is then collected from the central artery to the interlobular veins, and from interlobular veins, it drains to hepatic vein and then ultimately into the inferior vena cava. So you should know this structure, hexagonal structure of liver, in which hepatocytes are present. There is a central vein, portal vein, and artery, hepatic artery. And this blue line, blue dot like structure, in between you can see this orange arrow which goes out. So what is this? This is the bile secretion. The orange color shows it is going outside. The direction of arrow is outside. That means in between hepatocytes, hepatocells, hepatic cells, there is a secretion. Now the after taking the blood from this portal artery and hepatic artery, these hepatocytes, they secrete some bile pigments. You know that structure of bile. So this bile comes out from this middle part of the triangle. Okay. So this is the structure of hepatocytes arranged in a hexagonal manner. Okay. Clear to all? Is it clear to all? Is there any query?
No.
Okay. Okay. Now, this is the structure of histological structure of liver. And I don't think so it will be asked in detail in writing, but you should know this structure and you should be able to tell the examiner during Viva exam, Viva exam, it might be asked what is the main structure of a liver and how it works. Okay. So as I told earlier that there are functions. What are the functions of liver? As I told earlier, that metabolism, all the portal veins which drains from the small intestine, it comes to the liver in the form of portal veins, and these nutrients, they are metabolized. It goes for further metabolism in the liver. And so the function of liver is, first is metabolism. Second is the storage. It stores all the extra glucose, extra carbohydrate in the form of glycogen. Okay. Now, third function is synthesis. As we know that, as you just saw that it synthesizes the bile pigment, correct? Bile pigment and bile production is the main secretion from the liver, synthesis of liver. Now, second, again, the next function is excretion. As you know that some toxins which are coming from the portal vein or liver hepatic artery, these toxins, liver detoxifies all these toxic materials and helps to detoxify the blood. So its function is to, it extracts all the toxins from the blood and it purifies the blood. So liver is a main organ to detoxify the blood. The next is the protection. Now it protects us from these toxins. It forms some antibodies. It again helps us to protect from any infection antigens because it produces the antibodies. And as I said that it is a storage, it has a storing storage action also, like it stores the glycogen and fat and iron also. So it is a storage for fat, iron and glycogen. Okay, these are the functions of liver. So any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, should we repeat again all these things. There are in Chaurasia, we have some relations between each surface, but I don't think so. You need to know all these in details. Relations to each surface, which organ is related with which surface. You just go through it first only once. You don't need to remember all these structures. Just you should know this proper structure of liver, how many lobes and borders and surfaces and the ligaments. Ligaments is the important part for liver. You should know all these structures.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, what is hepatogastrial ligament and hepatoduodenal ligaments?
So, see, these ligaments which connects the peritoneum folds, which goes up to the duodenum, they form the duodenal ligament.
Okay.
Which goes to the gastric region or up to the stomach. It's called as gastric. So, these abdominal peritoneum folds are there on the liver. They are attached with the other organs also, and they form a contained structure, and it is called as ligament. And these are two additional ligaments also, you can say. But the main prominent ligament, you should know that these six ligaments, these are the prominent. And ligamentum teres is the remnant, or it's the remaining part of umbilical artery. Correct? And similarly, the ligamentum venosum, in fetus, you know that the fetus circulation, you know that hepatic portal vein is directly connected with the inferior vena cava, because there is no structure, there is a liver is in under development, so there are no hepatocytes and there is no need to supply the liver at that time. So directly the portal vein, it connects with the inferior vena cava. And afterwards, when the liver gets developed properly, now the blood portal vein directly goes to the liver, and afterwards the hepatic veins, they join the inferior vena cava. So the remaining part of that joining between portal vein and inferior vena cava, it forms the ligamentum venosum. Okay, so ligamentum venosum is a remaining part of this joining, and this portal hepatic arterial part, umbilical artery part, they form the remaining part of ligamentum teres. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Any doubt? How's your study going on? Kab hai aapki exam? Next month hai na sabki?
Nahi ma'am, next month nahi hai. December mein shayad. अक्टूबर दिसंबर में.
अच्छा, किसी ने मुझे नेक्स्ट मंथ का कुछ तो भेजा था, ये टाइम
वो बैकलॉग वाले स्टूडेंट्स का था वो.
ओके 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 ओके, सो अक्टूबर दिसंबर में होगा. ओके, सो टेल मी व्हिच नेक्स्ट पार्ट यू वांट टू लर्न फ्रॉम मी, आई विल डू अकॉर्डिंगली. आपको ये एनाटॉमिकल ऑर्गन्स एनाटॉमी चाहिए या दूसरा कोई पार्ट चाहिए सिखाना? आपको समझ में नहीं आ रहा है? हेलो, हेलो, आवाज नहीं आ रही है आपकी प्रॉपरली.
सेंस ऑर्गन्स.
सेंस ऑर्गन्स, ओके, चलेगा. फिर स्किन और नोज, टंग और आई, ये सारे सेंस ऑर्गन्स हम नेक्स्ट टाइम देखेंगे. इसमें से कौन सा आपको चाहिए वो बता दीजिए पहले, फिर आई विल कवर दैट. ओके
ओके मैम.
ओके ओके, बाय बाय, सी यू नेक्स्ट फ्राइडे.
ओके मैम, थैंक यू.
ओके, या.